Yes. Satlin, am I audible now? Yes. Okay, fine. Switch on your camera, Satlin. Okay, Saklin, you can see, but I cannot see you. I think, yeah, now I can see you. Yes. Yeah, fine. Abdullah, switch on your camera. Yes. Humaira, please switch on your camera. Okay, last time I gave you end of the unit integer question.
I did that and posted.
I have received most of your answer sheets. Only those who have not done, what is the issue? Amina, Saklin, and Safiya, why you could not submit the assignment? And also, yeah, Muazzam and Mudabbir. This time, yeah, Mudabbir, I got just your homework, but Muazzam, I didn't get your assignment.
Ma'am, I didn't understand the last question.
Yeah, Muazzam, I didn't get yours, but Mudabbir, I got.
Ma'am, I did the assignment, but I did not send the picture.
Yeah, you didn't hand in, so that is why. Because I was surprised, because usually I get your assignments together. I just got Mudabbir's assignment. Okay. Yes, Amina, what was the issue? Amina, Saklin, and Safiya?
I didn't understand the last question.
I gave you the answer in chat, in this with the assignment only, private chat. I gave you the answer also. Just check it. Please check Google Classroom for assignments, okay? And today I have uploaded the list of materials also for the science experiment. So just confirm me yes or no in Google Classroom also. You can say that yes, I have got it, or no also, okay?
Yes, one meant that we needed to find three numbers which product was 1001.
Which, yes. I will discuss those questions also. Some questions, most of you have done mistake in some question. I was asking Amina. Yes, Amina, what is the problem?
I did not check it. I have to check.
You did not check it, the Google Classroom. It was given, I think, last week on Wednesday I gave. Please, I request everyone, please check Google Classroom and check your assignment. Maths, especially, check for maths assignment and do it. Saklin, why you didn't solve?
Ma'am, I also didn't understand one question.
You can solve rest of the questions, Safiya. Leave that question which you are not able to do. Whichever question, even if 4 or 5 questions you are not able to do, you have done, Saklin? Okay, fine. But I could not see because it's not visible. Okay, I'll just discuss some questions in which you have made mistakes. Some of you have done mistakes. Question number one, some of you have done it wrongly. Which city is the coldest? Is clear to you? Just open page number 18 in integers, end of the unit question. Okay, just check your answers. I'll just give you the answer. If any mistake is there, those who have done correctly, I've given them the remark that it is correct. And some of you have done wrongly. Ahmed, I think you have also made mistake in first question B part. What is the temperature difference between?
Ma'am, you're muted.
Yeah, actually. Yes.
We have to do the end of review, the end of unit review
question. I have uploaded it on Google Classroom also. B part, what is the temperature difference between Kuala Lumpur and Kiev? Whenever in integers difference is asked, always take the bigger number first, put a minus sign and take a smaller number second. So which one is bigger? Kuala Lumpur temperature and Kiev, which one is bigger? 18?
Yes, Kuala Lumpur.
18 is bigger and Kiev temperature is -4. What do you will do? 18 -4.
So we will add them, but we will we will add them and put the
actually place. You are adding it, but when you are writing, you are doing subtraction. Okay. 18 -4 becomes 18 +4. So the answer is 22. Some of you have written -22. Okay, so correct it. Those who have written -22. And then this question, at second question, at 9 p.m. the temperature in Kutz Garden was -2 degrees Celsius. During the night, temperature went down 5 degrees, and then it went up 10 degrees by midday the next day. What was the temperature at midday in Kutz Garden? So how much you have written? Mostly you have done correctly only. What did you do? Question number 2, Muneeb. -2 went down. So -5. -2, -5. How much it is?
-3 degrees Celsius.
Yes. Then it went up by 10 degrees. So -7 plus 10. How much it is?
3 degrees.
Plus 3 degrees the answer. Okay. Rest everyone has done correctly. Farhana, you made a mistake in question number 9. I think C part. Okay. Question number 9, C part is 26157. Okay. No, 26157. It should not be a multiple of 9. It should be multiple of 3 and not be multiple of 9. And rest, some of you have done mistake in question number 12. Question number 12 is simple. What is the smallest number that is a product of 3 different prime numbers? So smallest 3 prime numbers. What are 3 smallest prime numbers?
2.
Yes. 2. Then 2, 3 and 5. So multiply 2, 3 and 5. Get the answer. That is 30. And the last one is the number 1001 is the product of 3 prime numbers. One of them is 13. So just divide 1001 by 13. How much you are getting?
Ma'am, I got the answer.
Got the answer? So 1001 by 13. How much you are getting? I think 77.
77 and then?
Prime numbers are 11 and 7.
Yes.
Okay, so the product of 3 numbers are 13, 11 and 7. That is the answer. Is it clear, Abdullah? The last question. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Safiya?
Yes.
Clear? Now you will submit the assignment. Amina, Safiya, please do it.
Ma'am, which is the coldest? The answer is Kiev, right?
Which one?
Which coldest one? A is
coldest is not Kiev. Which one is coldest? Tell me. Which one is coldest?
Kuala Lumpur.
No, ma'am, it's Astana.
Amina, which one is coldest?
Coldest is Wellington.
Ma'am, can I say?
Coldest means lowest temperature. Which one?
Ma'am, but -4.
Astana.
Astana is the coldest because -10 is the lowest number, na? Lowest integer is -10, okay?
And -4 is also there.
But -10 is smaller than -4. -10 lies on the left-hand side of -4. So coldest is Astana. Okay, so today, again, now we'll start with a new chapter now.
Yes, ma'am. Sequences.
I'm not starting with sequences.
Then?
Ma'am, which chapter?
We'll start with decimal today. Decimal is also an important topic. So, I made a Google slide today. I won't be able to write it on the slide.
Ma'am, you can use annotate and you can write.
Yes, I can annotate. I don't know how to annotate. Okay, fine. I'll try now.
Now you have to go to view options and then you can annotate.
Ma'am, in our MacBook, there is no chapter.
Yes, I saw your annotate. Yes, I can do that. Yes, Muni, what were you saying?
Our notebook, ma'am, there is no chapter named decimal.
It is there. Third chapter is there. That is only decimal chapter. The name of the chapter is?
Place, value, ordering, and rounding.
Place, value, ordering, and rounding. See, the next page, it is decimal only. Okay?
Okay.
Again, now I'll give you a puzzle. Give your answer. Write down that you are using integers over here. Write the numbers -6, -4, 1, 2, 3, and 5 in the correct place so that each line cross adds up to 3. So that means write the numbers in this way such that the addition is 3. In this way also addition is 3. Okay. So just take 2 minutes time. Do it in your notebook. How will you arrange the numbers? so that this addition is 3 and this addition is 3 and you don't need to repeat the numbers. You have a minus 4, so you can do, okay, correct. 5 to 7 minus 4. Okay, now this way also it should be. See, one hint is minus 4 you put in this side. Okay? Because in one line you will take minus 6 and one line put minus 4. So don't put it, because it should be a common number. Middle one should be a common number. So 5, 2 and minus 4 is a correct combination. Just make it differently. 2, 5 and minus 4, do like this. 2, 5, minus 4. Do like this. Correct. 2, 5, minus 4 here. Okay. Now arrange this number. Rest of the numbers will be here. Is it correct? Just check rest of the number. Rest of the number is what? Minus 6 plus 5 is minus 1. What is left now? 2 is done already. 2 is done. Don't write 2.
3.
3, yes. You write 3. 3 is left. 1 is left.
And minus 3 plus 6. 5,
8. 8, is it 3? Just check. 5 minus 6, yes, it is 3. Yeah, it was correct. Now, why did you remove minus 6 over here? Put minus 6. Yes, this is correct now. Now do this one. I think I got, I gave you a solution also. See the second one. 4 minus 5, 7 minus 6, the same way you can do it. Okay? Same way you can arrange so that addition is 0. Okay, I'm not making you do. Now we'll start with our topic. Just erase this. Okay, where do you use decimal in our day-to-day life? Where do we use decimal in our day-to-day life? Can you just everyone give me one examples? Where
can
do
I
we?
Can I say temperature?
Okay, let me call you one by one. Yes, we'll start with Amina. Amina.
Temperature.
For measuring temperature, okay. Munim?
Percentages. Marks.
Percentages, okay. Muazzam?
Ma'am, sometimes in temperatures.
Temperatures already, Amina has told temperature.
Okay. Ma'am, supermarkets for the prices.
For the prices. So, finding out the total amount of how much you have bought. So there also decimal is required. Okay, Muazzam, Mudabbir, you tell.
I'm in storage, in mobile storage.
GB you're telling?
Yes.
How much GB is used? Okay, yes, there also. Okay. Abdullah, where do you use decimals in our day-to-day life?
Ma'am, and like when we buy things for prices.
For prices already Muazzam told. Where else? So many places you see decimals now. Think.
Ma'am, can I say?
Yes, Farhana.
Ma'am, in measurement. Sometimes you have
in
to
measurements. Measure. Correct. You, whatever you measure, you're measuring length, you need decimal.
Solving maths also.
Solving maths also you need decimal. Yes. Saklin, where else you find decimals? Where do we use?
In written chart.
Saklin, I'm asking Saklin. Saklin, not audible. You're not audible.
Ma'am, he wrote the answer in chat.
Okay, he wrote in chat. What did he write?
Time.
Stopwatch time, correct? Like when you're measuring time, right?
Yes, age.
Age also, fine. Ahmed, where do you use decimals?
I'm sometimes in months also, when we say the date, like August 1 point something, like we say, no.
Okay. Okay, let Ahmed answer.
In physics.
In physics, where do we use in physics?
Rocket science.
Sorry?
Rocket science.
Rocket science, so you need to be specific. You are measuring in physics also, measuring, doing experiments. We need decimals, okay? So in maths also, we need decimals. Humaira, you tell.
Ma'am, decimal is used for measuring time and also intelligence or solving of math sums.
Solving of math sums, yes. So, see, all of you, Safiya, did you answer? Yes, Safiya?
Money,
okay, money also we have covered. So, what did you see when you gave so many examples?
Ma'am, even in weight.
So, measurement may weight, length, age, time. So, basically, in measurement, when you need precise measurement, exact measurement, you need decimal, right? Every time you cannot have values in whole numbers only. Always, you cannot say that I want 10 centimeter of paper. It can be 10.5 centimeter.
Ma'am, we use decimal in weather also, na?
Decimal in weather also. Temperatures, when you are measuring temperature. Temperature is not always whole number. It cannot be 25 degree always. It can be 25.2 degree Celsius also. It can be 25.8 degree Celsius. So when you are measuring something accurately, precise measurement, you need decimals, okay? Yeah. Yes, Muni.
Percentages come under measurement only, no?
Percentage also measurement means what percentage, suppose something is, suppose you're using something in measurement. So what percentage of salt you're adding in water? So that is also, that can be in percent, that in percentage also decimals can be there. Like I'm using 50% of salt in water. So 50 means so much salt I'm using. So this is whole number. When I say 25.5% of salt I'm using in water, in salt solution, okay? So this way in measurement, in experiments when we are doing, you need decimal for exact quantity because always you won't be having. Now, if I say what is your age, age cannot be because today is not your birthday. So it cannot be a whole number age. So you have to tell me this many years and this many months. Okay. You can say that. What is your age, Safiya? Can you calculate your, when is your birthday?
It
is at 1.12 May. January 12.
You are January 12.
2006.
1.12.
Ma'am, 4th May 2006.
2006, well, what is the month?
May.
So how many years and how many months you will calculate? And if you convert it in decimal, what will you get? Now everyone just calculate this. This
Ma'am,
is your
how? Homework.
Calculate your age in decimals. Okay? This is your homework.
Ma'am, how? Can you show once?
How? Okay, I'll tell you the method. Age years, you know how much is the what which year is it? 2020?
Yes.
2020 minus 2006. Okay, so that is on which month you said your birthday is in which month?
May.
So on May, which May? What is the date?
4th
May. So on 4th May, you completed 14 years, right?
Yes.
After May, how many month is gone till September? Till 4th September, how many month has gone? May, June, July, August, and September. Five months.
4 months. June, July, August.
How should I do mine?
4th May was your birthday, na?
Yes.
So after 4th May, when 4th, after May, June is there.
Ma'am, we don't count September, right?
We will count September because this is
fine.
Okay, so 5 months. So 5 by 12, you will find out in decimal. So that is your value, 14.
Ma'am, how do I find out my day in decimal?
What is, how much is your age? When is your birthday?
My birthday is on 10th March.
10th March. So after March, how many days, how many months have gone?
14.6.
April, May, June, July, August, September. So on 10th September, it is 6 months. 6 months means 6 And 1 year, how many months are there? 12 months. So 6 by 12 is how much? 1 by 2, which is 0.5. So you are, and how many years? How many years? Which year date of birth is there?
Ma'am, we have to minus 20.
Amina, 11 years, 12 years. What is your age?
11.
So 11.5 is your answer, or 12.5. What is, whatever is your whole number? That is your answer.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am, we have to manage 2020 from our birthday year, no?
Right. Okay. Okay, we'll do it in the next class when we study more about decimal. So decimal in our everyday life, you see, whenever we need precise measurement, you need, whenever you need accurate measurement, accurate value, okay? Okay, everybody has written their birthdays, but I want you to find out in decimals, okay? On September of the same day, like if Abdullah, Ahmed, your birthday is on 28th April. So on 28th September, what is the value in decimal that you have to
ma'am.
Find?
Ma'am, I subtracted, ma'am. I got
two. Yes, Abdullah.
My birthday was yesterday only.
Oh, yesterday? Okay, belated birthday wishes, Abdullah. So you are having accurate birthday now, okay? Which year? How many years old you are now, Abdullah?
14.
14. So you are exact 14 now, okay? So you don't need decimal now. Because you are exact. Because you had yesterday birthday. So what I was telling you, whenever you need exact precision, always you will not get a whole number value in measurement. So we need decimal values for expressing the measurement part accurately. When it is accurate, you need a decimal. Suppose if I say how much distance is there from your school to your house, it can be whole number also, but if you measure it accurately, it can be in decimal. So like 2.25 kilometer from school, okay? Somebody is 7.5 years old to height is 1.23 meter tall. So these are the accurate values you need decimal. You know what is decimal? This point is called as decimal. And you know what is, what does decimal mean? Decimal is, decimal has come from which word? Can you define which word? Decimal. Decimal, that word is there in the decimal word only. Decimal means? You can try. Farhana, can you try?
Ma'am, anything means decide.
Decide, okay, nice try, Amina. Deci is, you are going on the right path. It depend, it is from the word deci, and deci is for 10. Deci means, you know, decade is there. Decade also 10 years. Know that decade is 10 years. One decade is 10 years. So deci is also for 10. Decimal means base of 10. Okay. Now, how it is base of 10, we'll study why it is decimal. And see, everyday life, how do we use in amounts of money, temperature, distances? These are the points, times you measure. So these are in day-to-day life, we measure decimal in this way. Weight also in decimal. Okay, so decimal number is represented like this. This is a decimal number, 45.786. We don't read it like 45.786. This is a wrong way to read. So whenever decimal is there, decimal before the decimal, this part is your whole number part. So this whole number you will read as you read the whole number, 245, 5245. So this way you will read the left hand side of decimal. But after decimal, this number is the fractional part, all or the decimal part. We read it independently, like 786. You will not say 786. Okay, 45.786. Now what is this? Just observe 45. Now decimal, the region here is greater than 1. You say whatever number you write here, it will be greater than 1. And whatever number you write here, it is less than 1. So before the decimal part, this part is always greater than 1. And this part, 0.786, is always less.
Ma'am, you are mute. Safiya, you muted, ma'am.
Yeah. Then I can't unmute.
Ha, now it is fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Safiya, you muted me. Huh? Okay, so what I was telling? Huh? So this is a decimal number. Now you already know this is whole number. This is whole number part and this is the decimal part. Also fractional part, you can say, okay? Now, whatever number you write here, it is greater than one. You know the place value. If I write something, if you write 245, you know what is the place value of 2, what is place value of 4, and what is place value of 5? You know that? 245 is what? 2 into 100?
Plus 200 plus 445
plus 5 into 1. So that is a place value of whole number. Same way we have a place value of decimal number also. But here, just the digit just next to decimal will be having the place value 1 by 10. So 7 into 1 by 10. Then next value is 1 by 100. So 8 into 1 by 100. And then last one is 6 into 1 by 1000 and so on. As the number proceeds, the zero will be increased one by one. Okay?
Ma'am, in decimal, the part that is on like on the right side, on the left side, that will be ones, please.
The part on the left-hand side will be ones, tens, hundred, thousand, like this. And part on the right-hand side will be one-tenth, tenth, T-E-N-T-H. 100 and 1000. Okay, TH you have to add. Here, what do we write? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, like that we go, right? And here we'll write 1/10. Here, no ones is there. 1/10, 100th, and 1000th. Like this, we proceed. So, if you see this, just see this place value chart. When we adjust the place, next to the decimal, these are ones, tens, hundred. When we proceed on the left-hand side, it increases, every digit increases 10 times. And when we proceed on the right-hand side, every digit decreases 10 times. It is decrease in 10. So that is why it is decimal. See, tenths, we write tenths. It is 1 by 10. Hundredths, THS. It is 1 by 100. And it is thousands, which is 1 by 1000.
I have a question.
Yes, Amina.
So the numbers that are on the left side, they are greater, or the numbers that are on the right side are greater?
They are always greater than the decimal part, okay? When you say 23 will be greater than if I write 0.23, okay? 0.23 and 23. So 23 is here, 0.3 is 0.2 and 3. So 0.23 is smaller than 23. Is it clear, Amina? Left hand side, the number is greater, right hand side, number is smaller. This thing is clear to you all? This is just the basic. I think you must have done also earlier. See, when we write a number 456, 6 is at 1's place, 5 is at 10's place, and 4 is at 100's place. So you, when you move from left to right, you are getting bigger. 1's, 10's, 100. So 10 times bigger in every digit. But when we move towards the left, you are getting 10 times smaller. So 400 is now smaller, 10 times 50. This is 10's place, and this is 1's place. So you are moving right-hand side, you are moving 10 times smaller. When you're moving left hand side, you're moving 10 times bigger. Here also in decimal, you see when you move from here, you're moving 10 times smaller. Hundreds, tens, ones. And what is 10 times smaller than one? 1 by 10. So when we move after the decimal, it is 1 by 10. When we move further over here, it will be 1 by 100. So when we move towards right, we are moving 10 times smaller. Means 10 dividing, you will be dividing by 10 every digit. And when you move towards left, it will be 10 times bigger. Is it clear, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So when we write this, you see, this is whole number part. 143 is whole number part. Munib, how will you read this number? How will you read it?
143.056.
Yes. One way is 143.056. This is in number form. Now in word form, how will we write? In word form, we'll say 143,056,000. Why? Because you will see the last digit. Last digit is at which place? Thousands place.
Thousand
because
place.
This is 1/10, this is 1/100th, and this is 1,000. So this is 56,000 because you don't have 1/10th place over here. So you will write 143,056,000. Okay, THS shows that it is after the decimal. TH is written, that means it is after the decimal. 23.6. How will you say this, Amina? 23.6. This is a number form. How will you say this?
23 and 6/10.
Yes, 6/10. It's written over here, 6/10. So this is a fractional part, or you can say decimal part. So this is the place value division. You can see decimal is over here, units, tens, hundreds, and here it will be 1/10, 100, 1,000, 1/10,000. It goes towards right like that. Okay. See in detail also, ones, tens, hundred, decimal is there, 1/10, 1/100, 1/1,000, 1/10,000, 1/100,000. So more is the number of digit, more will be the zeros in the denominator. Okay. So this is the place value. Is it clear, everyone? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine? Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So whole number part. Now 106 and 500s. Now 5 and then 100s is there. That means 5 should be at 100s place. So what you will write? 106.05, not 5 only. Okay, 0.05, because 5 should be at which place? 100s place.
100 means it should be at 100s place.
Yes, so that is why 5 should be here at 100th place. 3.054. How will you write 3 and 54,000. Because 4 is at thousands place. Understood? If it is written in
yes.
One, how will you write in numbers? Now, 9/10 is 9 by 10 or 0.9. Okay? This thing is clear. How do you write decimal in fraction? 0.9 is written as 9 by 10. Because this is what? 9 into 1 by 10. So, 9 into 1 by 10 is what? 1 by 10. Fine?
Yes.
Okay, next one. Now see, how will you compare two decimals? Comparison of two whole number is clear to everyone. You can compare from the from extreme left, you compare. Same way in decimal also. How will we compare? You just
ma'am,
see.
Can I say, I know.
Yes, yes, Muneeb, tell me.
Ma'am, first, ma'am, after decimal, you see which number is bigger. Here, 6 and 6 is there. So, right. you will do nothing. You will go to the next. You will go to the right. Then 3.
Yes.
Then you
yes.
will see which number is bigger, 3 or 5.
Yeah.
5 is bigger, so it means that 35.657 is bigger.
Correct. So,
why will we not see the one that is before the decimal?
Because before the decimal also we have to see, but here before the decimal you have same number. So, you cannot decide. If I had written 34.638 and 35.657, so from 34 and 35 it was clear that this was smaller, okay? If I write 34.638 and 35.657, then this is smaller because already you got it from the whole number comparison only. Is it clear, Amina? But here whole number is same, then you have to shift further in the decimal part. Fine, Amina?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, when you are writing decimal, after the decimal, in the last digit, even if you write 0, it doesn't change the meaning of this number. If I write 10, if I write 20, if I write 10 also, it doesn't change the value of 8.5. It will remain 8.5 only. But if I write 8.05, it will change the value. Okay? So in the end, value of 0...
It is exactly opposite before the decimal.
Yes. It is exactly opposite of the whole number part. Because if I write 12 and then I write 120, the value changes 100 times. Okay? But in decimal, in the end, after the decimal part, in the end, if you write 0, the value does not change. Is it clear, Safiya?
Ma'am, if you write 0 before 8,
then it will change.
Ma'am, because it will change, because...
Before 8 also, it will not change, okay? If you write 0 before 8, the value does not change. Yes, Munir?
Ma'am, it will not... after, if you put 0, it will not change because after 10, 100 and 0 will not have any 100
any value. Any place value.
But 5 will have it.
Yes. Because 0 by 1000... is 0 only. 0 by 10,000 is 0 only. So the value does not change over here. Okay? So it can be written 15 can be written as 15.0, 15.00 or any number of zeros you can increase. So these are the fundamentals of decimal. The value does not change. 34.7. Now how do we draw it? 30 circles are there plus 4 circles and 7 by 10. 0.7 is what? 7 by 10. 10 is divided into 7 part and 7 part is colored. Okay, I can have it. Just see. 6 tenth means 6 by 10 in fraction and 0.6 in decimal. Okay, 500 means 5 by 100 in fraction and 0.5
in...
Yes. 3200 means 32 by 100 in fraction. So that is why we say this as fractional part also. And 0.32 as decimal number. 267 by 1000, which is 0.267 in decimal. Okay. This thing is clear?
Yes,
everyone?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next is, now see, this is fraction. All of you have done this in fraction. You know what value is shaded over here? Amina?
One.
Out of how many?
10. 1/10.
1/10.
So 1/10 is in decimal. It is how much? 1/10. Which is
0.1.
Yes, 0.1. So now if I give you another one, what value is this?
4/10.
4 out of 10. So what is in decimal?
0.4.
0.4. Yes, so this is 4/10. Now see 17.48, how it is written? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 17 whole numbers. This is 4/10. So how? 4 out of 10. So this is 4/10. And this is 100. 10 into 10, this is 100. How many are shaded? 8. So 8 out of 100 is 8 by 100. Okay. So
17.48.
0.08,
right?
Yeah, ma'am. What is the funny thing going on in decimal? Or are you sitting in another separate chat class?
No, ma'am, we are not chatting.
Then, what is so funny in decimal here? You can tell me so that I can also laugh a little. I'm too serious. Tell me.
No, ma'am. It was not about decimals.
Then about what?
Ma'am, about something else. I'm nothing.
Share, na. I know Saklain is also there. That's why his camera is always
on. No, ma'am, Saklain is not in the meeting.
Huh?
Saklain is not in the meeting.
Saklain is not in the meeting, but it is showing over your window.
Ma'am, it is showing, but he is actually not there.
Acha. Not there. Then share with me. You don't want me to know what you are doing with the funny jokes. Even I want to laugh a little.
No, we were drawing something with pencil and then making some funny figures. That's why we were laughing.
Okay, you can show me the figure. You are drawing my figure.
Not yours, ma'am.
Then, yeah, I can see my caricature. Even I enjoy art also. Huh? I love art. You can show me. I like drawing.
Ma'am, but now it is fully scribbled.
Okay, fine. So next time when you draw, please show me also, okay?
Okay.
Even I enjoy drawing part. Okay, coming back to our topic now. What decimal number is illustrated here? You need to tell me. Who will tell me this? Abdullah?
Can I tell? Can I tell?
Who will tell me?
Ma'am, can you hear me, ma'am?
Yes, Abdullah, now I can hear you. Okay, Muneem, you give the answer.
0.9.
This is 0.9. Why? Because 9 by 10. So it will be 0.9. What will you say in word, Amina? What will you say this number in word?
0 and 9.
No.
9 10.
9 10. No need to say 0. Just say 9 to 10.
9 10.
Okay, 9-10.
0.9.
0.9. You will not say Muneem. 9 10.
Only 9 10.
Yes. Okay. Now, Amina, you give me this answer. How many are shaded? First of all, count. This is 10. 10 out of? You don't need to count. 10 into 10. This is 100 blocks.
It's 20 blocks.
No, this is 100.
Yeah.
So, 10. What will be the answer? 10 out of how many?
10.00.
No, not like that. 10 is shaded. No, somebody else. Amuni, you have already answered. We'll answer. Safiya, can you answer me? How will you represent this number as decimal? First, you give me fraction part, then you tell me decimal. This is 100. I already told you. This is 100 grid.
Can I say?
I know how to do.
Who will answer then? Mudabbir, can you answer?
I'm 10 hundred.
10 hundredth is in words. How will you write in decimal?
10 upon 100.
0.1.
Fraction. 10 upon 100. 0.10.
On decimal, it's 0.10.
Decimal.
0.10.
10 is there. Where is 8? 8 is not here. Yes.
0.10.
Am I safe?
Yes, Muneem.
Ma'am, 0.0,
ma'am, 0.0 and 10. 0.01.
Last zero doesn't change the value, so you don't need to say. Samkhya, why it is not 0, why it is not 0.10? Because I told you,
after
10 hundred. So this is what? 10 by 100. 10 by 100 is what? 0.01. Okay? One should be at 100th place. Okay? Okay, next one. 100 grid. Okay?
I can't see.
First, give me a fraction part. Farhana, give me the fraction part, then decimal.
Ma'am, I can't see. I can see the previous slide.
No, this slide is not visible. Farhana, I cannot hear you. Unmute yourself. No, still, I think some problem is there. Not audible, Farhana. Okay, chat mein you have written. Saklin is there in the class. He is answering me. Okay, Saklin, coming to your question also. Wait. First, let us complete this. Who will give me the answer? Humaira, can you give me the answer for this shaded one?
Green one.
Yes, green one. Ahmad, anyone? Farhana is not able to answer. She's
ma'am, can I say?
96 are shaded out of 100, right?
96 is shaded.
9 out of 10.
Not 9 out of 10. This
I mean, yeah. 9 out of...
Ma'am, Farhana gave the answer.
Farhana, a little bit mistake is there. So,
0.96
is the answer. Why? Because this is 96 by 100. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah,
we don't need to put that 0 because so this is 96,
100th. So 6 should be at 100th place. Okay.
Thank you.
0.96. Okay. Mm. Answer is 0.96. Yes, Saklin. Correct answer. See, Saklin is there in the class. Muazzam and Mudabbir.
It might be because of the internet connection, so we were not able to.
Maybe it's like that. Okay. So we did this. Just a moment. What is this number?
1, 2, 3.
Just
10, 10,
and this is 1.
Ma'am, can I say?
No,
21 out of 100.
Answer, Humaira, Abdullah, anyone? Give me the answer.
21 out of 100.
Correct, that is fraction part. In decimal, what will you write? 21 out of 100. This is.
Ma'am, I will give.
0.21.
Correct, 0.21, because this is 21 out of 100, which is 2100th. Okay, 2100th means 1 should be at 100th place. So 0.21. Okay, next one. Okay, now Muneeb, you tell. What is the value?
Mom, 0.6.
Yes, because it is 6/10. Clear, Amina? What is it? 6/10.
I want to do the 100 brick wall.
Okay, now who will answer me? This one. Ahmed, are you there? Please answer this question. What is the value of this in decimal representation? First,
0.52.
0.52. Saklin, what is the mistake you said here? What is the mistake? 0.52 when you are saying, what is the mistake over here?
0.52, ma'am.
0.52 is the answer.
The decimal, we don't say.
Yes.
11, we don't say like 21, 22 like that.
Correct. So after decimal, you have to say 52.
We don't say the numbers names.
52 by 100. So answer will be 0.52. Okay. Humaira, can you give me this answer? How many are shaded? 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and how much is 1 less than 60? How much is
0.59.
First, 59 block out of 100 is 0.59, or you can say 59 hundredths.
Humaira, can you raise hand?
Okay. Amina, how much is this?
This is same like the first one, okay?
Ma'am, 6 out of 10.
This is 0.6.
0.6, ma'am, 0.6.
Ma'am, there are two 0.6, ma'am.
Yeah, two 0.6. Colors are different. What is the value of this? Tell me.
Ma'am, 100 out of 100 is 1.
Correct, very good. So this is
0.01.
Only one.
0.1.
Amma, something what?
No, 0.1.
Only one, because
0.0.
100 upon 100 is 1.
0.0.
No, decimal is one.
Only one.
Only one, because this is 100 out of 100, full marks. Okay?
No.
So this is 1. This does not mean 100 out of 100 is 1. 1 marks nahi hai, theek hai? 100 out of 100 is full marks, but in decimal it is 1. Okay? Now if I say this, I want this number together. This is 1 you already told. How much is this?
15 out of 100.
0.15.
So when I take this together, this is 1.15. Okay?
Because 1.15.
This whole is 1.
And in the fraction, we have 15 upon 100, right?
Yes. In fraction, 15 upon 100, which is 1/15 upon 100. 1 here, 15 upon 100. So it is 1.15. Okay, last one.
3 out of 100. 3 upon 100,
0.04. 0.04. 0.04. Yes, Amina, it is correct. 0.04, because it is 4 out of 100.
4 upon 100.
Yes. So now it is clear. How do we find out the decimal part and fraction part? Okay.
Yes.
In this class we'll be doing addition, multiplication, subtraction of decimals. Fine.
Yes. Ma'am.
Yes.
I got my that eighth. You said no. My answer is 11.85.
Which answer?
That age one you said no.
Answer. Okay.
11.85.
Write down on Google Classroom your date of birth, year and month of birth and the answer. Okay, then I'll come to know.
But we have to write the method also.
No need to write the method. Just write it in decimal. But you need to write your date of birth with year. Then only I can check whether your decimal part is correct or not. Okay?
Okay.
Bye everyone. I'll be stopping.
Bye.
Stopping it now. Okay. Bye everyone. See you in the next class. Just check Google Classroom for the things, materials, and inform me whether you would be able to get it or not. Fine? Bye.